So, a couple of days ago, we had to be rescued by the Danish sea rescue because we lost the oil from the hydraulic steering, and we have now fixed it, and it has taken several days and a small fortune. That's because we have not only fixed the problem, but we have also done the system better. So, follow me, and I will show you what we have done to improve the hydraulic system on this boat. This here is the top of the rudder, and here we have the emergency tiller. I have fixed it with duct tape, so it will be ready when we need it. That was also the solution we had earlier, but when I took this tiller and tried to move the rudder, it was stuck, and that was because it was still oil in the cylinder here. And what have we done to improve that? Well, we have made a bypass here with a valve. So when I turn this valve, we are bypassing the hydraulic cylinder, and we can now turn the rudder with the tiller. And then back to normal operation. So that is a big improvement. And now I know that I can steer the boat with the emergency tiller, even if it is oil in the system. The leakage was this hose here that was leaking oil. And when you don't have oil in the system, the steering is failing. In addition to adding the bypass for the oil here, we also changed the pump on the upper steering because we figured, we found out that the steering pump on the upper steering was lacking valves for preventing the oil to go back. So when the autopilot was steering the boat, the wheel was turning. It has been like that for a long time, but I've always figured that this is not right. And after discussing this with the hydraulic professional here in Denmark, we ended up by changing the complete pump for the upper steering. That cost a small fortune, but we now have a very good system, a bulletproof system, and I know that I have steering for the rest of my life, so to say. So we spent a few days here in Grenaa, Denmark, and we got very good help from Grenaa Hydraulics, and now we are ready to go south, down to Kiel, do the Kieler Canal, and then over to England, and let's see how the rest of this journey is. So inside here we have the hydraulic pump for the upper steering position, and now this pump is with non-returning valves, so the oil is flowing one direction and one direction only, so not going back, and that will do that this system is working better together with an autopilot. The pump was the original pump from 1982, so more than 40 years old pump. So you could say that it was on time changing it anyway. So as you might know, the Nauticat has an indoor steering position as well, and now we have the same pump in the indoor steering position and the outdoor steering position. So the indoor steering position, we changed the pump a couple of years ago. Well, I say we, it was not we because it was before I bought the boat. The boat came with a new pump on the indoor steering position, but on the outdoor steering position, it was the original 40-year-old pump. And now it's brand new, so the boat is getting better and better for every day. I just want to show you the last pump in the boat. This hydraulic pump is the autopilot, and that is pumping oil in the same circuit as the two steering wheels. So I have one inside steering wheel, one outside steering wheel, and also this electric hydraulic pump that is using the same oil. And that is down in the engine room, as I call it. And as you see, this is where it's located. So now the old lady is back on track and ready to go. I just want to give a great thank you to Grenaa Hydraulic that fixed this problem on a very short notice. I came in, they understood my problem, they fixed it, and
off we go. Thank you.